We're gonna start soon, in like 5 minutes. We're just testing things and getting started. But hello, we're gonna talk about politics and gaming for an hour. I hope this streams the whole time because I'm just gonna leave it alone down here. So, we'll see, this is an experiment.
By not figuring out some way to wirelessly have the music from the
Thank you. Exactly. Okay. So club practice again. So I totally love guns, but let me talk about capitalism now. So I think, so specifically in the cyberpunk genre, all of this happens in other genres too. There's usually this plot line where the big bad guy is super rich, right? And we get to witness these super rich people in these weird exotic lifestyles that look like they have slaves or they do all the things, right? And then ultimately, in a lot of these stories, the author comes down and says, but the secret is they're either a sexual predator or they're a Nazi, right? And then they get exposed and everything goes bad, okay? So just say, like, talking about harsh terms or whatever. But ultimately, like, the real violence here is not that there are these rich people who also engage in bad behaviors, but ultimately you have a massive wealth consolidation and you have people that control a lot of things while the rest of us are fighting over scraps, right? And another problem, like, the real horror is not that bad person doing bad things in secret, because proxy poor people do those things sometimes too, but that there may be, you know, building pipelines on indigenous lands where we have trees, you know, or they're creating other economic systems that create the true horror in the setting, right? Last thing about this, sorry if I talk too much. Last thing about this is, when we create this narrative that there is a billionaire who is evil, what we're doing at the same time is saying that there's a billionaire who's a good guy, right? When really it's about the system and the inequity that's the problem, it's not the avatars of wealth, right?
So it sounds like what you're saying is to go beyond the trope of easy bad guys.
Yeah, I would say I'm a billionaire bad guy who's actually a super humanitarian, right? Like, that's more compelling, that's more powerful. Like, those two go before a lot of these guys. Like, I know what's going
to spend $1 million a day on $1 billion a day.
Right. Exactly. So, you know, we think about folks like Bill Gates and the big foundation, we think about Warren Buffett, a lot of legs, like him, because he has leftist politics or whatever, but ultimately these old vampires of oppressive systems. So I think they make compelling bad guys instead of just usual hidden sexual predator nuts.
I want to switch back to guns for a second. One of the things that I experienced
resolve things through this versus this or that versus that, so you actually can limit the terms on which the next can be rolled.
Right, so I don't know, like the past the right races, which I don't know what I have to make up, but I don't want to do it. So we're like after races, right? And we have these little water ships that we fly around, and it's like a class of thirds. And I really want to get fast. So
so if you roll this, I mean fast or thirds, right?
Well,
how to develop it. You might try something new, but like not everyone's like, no, we all music that I think is thrown to lots of people. And I read a lot about queer people and about queer women in particular, queer women in gender roles and trans roles, and throughout history. So kind of, I have a little sneaky, like, it's kind of a funny, fantasy creature. But it also teaches about the economy history. I think the education aspect of games is a huge portion of that.
So important. So important.
But the, like, I don't know in general, and I'm interested
So, like, creators like myself and the marginalized community, you don't get to be comfortable, right? You don't get to be like, well, I tried, therefore I'm just going home. Like, you don't get that. Nobody else gets that, so you shouldn't either, so shut up. Sorry.
So you gotta try and not be guaranteed success in the world.
Yes.
So I'll cop to a little bit of this too. I did something with Miss Mindy where a character sheet is your current record and it's an extended counterform. Everything in the being is things that the bad guys say about you. Stats, so means, mood, and opportunity, and stuff like that. So in this game, there is a filling bubble for your gender, where for all. And then Josh did some fun stuff with the character sheet where it says, where is this? I'm not going to be fun. Anyway, so the point of this, and I put text in there, yes, okay, boy, girl, for official use only is the third, like, box in that gender section. So it's inviting you, which I didn't know about that, it's all good, whatever, that's fine. It's inviting him, he's inviting people to say, oh yeah, there's another option that this thing's allowing you. You know, and that was my purpose. There's text in there that says, this is the authority's form on you. If your gender doesn't fit into one of these two things, then your looks indicate that. Because this is the whole game is really hard to see. I do know that one or two people have been offended by it. Because they didn't have the option. They were explicitly didn't have the option, even though you totally do, to define that gender. And when I was doing the supplement of one person on the gender or a person, and I was like, is there a way we can work within that system? And what she said, which was so great, was first of all, this is a world where gender and sexuality are not, it's a terrible world, but those are not things that you are bothered about. And second of all, she said, player decide the gender, decide whether or not you tell them. So it helps to have friends who make your iffy stuff in them. Alright, so we're getting close to the end, about a half an hour. So let's tackle, I think, the biting one here that I like. So how do games or gamers or game companies fight actual nonsense that I must in real life from?
It sounds like you're very specific in mind. Come on.
No one would say that. The non-binary and trans communities
they've already established, like, there's no particular reason to do what I'm going to
have. Yeah, yeah, well, you said fantastic, but it's time for
me. Is this the original Mary Black?
Yes.
Engage too much. He's basically adding to the white suburbs of the internet, running away. So one thing allies shouldn't do is flee a space because it's getting too hot. You should be there hard, and because you're not a marginalized person, you should go truly hard. You should go on the offense. You should invade Nazi space and not fucking run away from it.
Not going to
So let's do some time for Q&A.
What
will we discuss?
15
minutes. Great, yes. So perfect. You can take one of those two kinds of ownerships in it Then maybe it's not
whether that you interact with will determine whether or not you who that you interact with and the families you want to be part of will determine whether or not you become one person. If you go to jail, you better become a murderer. Because so can you
they have their own
Yeah.